Hello, and may the Lord be with you today, December 19th. Today the church remembers our first ancestors, Adam and Eve. Now you probably know a good deal about Adam and Eve. They were made on the sixth day of creation, and they were the pinnacle, God's most beloved creation, man and woman. Man created first, and then woman created for him for a suitable helper. And everything was perfect for a time. But you know that in Genesis 3, we get the fall into sin. When the serpent, the devil, Satan comes into the garden, tempts Adam and Eve, and drives them to sin against God. And from that point on, sin entered the world and it came to their children all the way down to us through that first sin. And what does this mean for us today? Well, it's appropriate that today, December 19th, we're getting close to Christmas, the day when Jesus was born, and we remember Adam and Eve. For as sin came into the world through one man, through Adam, justification, salvation came through one man as well. And on that note, our text for today is going to be from Romans chapter 5. Therefore, just as sin came into the world through one man, and death through sin, and so death spread to all men because all sinned, for sin indeed was in the world before the law was given, but sin is not counted where there is no law. Yet death reigned from Adam to Moses, even over those whose sinning was not like the transgression of Adam, who was a type of the one who was to come. But the free gift is not like the trespass. For if many died through one man's trespass, much more have the grace of God and the free gift by the grace of that one man, Jesus Christ, abounded for many. And the free gift is not like the result of that one man's sin. For the judgment following one trespass brought condemnation, but the free gift following many trespasses brought justification. For if, because of one man's trespass, death reigned through that one man, much more will those who receive the abundance of grace and the free gift of righteousness reign in life through the one man, Jesus Christ. Therefore, as one trespass led to condemnation for all men, so one act of righteousness leads to justification and life for all men. For as by the one man's disobedience the many were made sinners, so by the one man's obedience the many will be made righteous. Now the law came in to increase the trespass, but where sin increased, grace abounded all the more. So that as sin reigned in death, grace also might reign through righteousness, leading to eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Here in this reading from Paul from Romans 5, we see the point that sin came into the world through Adam. Through Adam and Eve's sin, all humanity fell. But through one man, through the gift that Jesus Christ gave on the cross and in his empty tomb, through that sacrifice, you and I, our fallen race, now abound in grace. So, today we look back to the very beginning of our time, of Adam and Eve, but also keep one eye focused in what will happen in just under a week. Keeping one eye focused on the next man, the new Adam who comes in Jesus Christ to save us from our sins. I invite you now to pray with me. Lord God, Heavenly Father, you created Adam in your image and gave him Eve as his helper. And after their fall into sin, you promised them a Savior who would crush the devil's might. By your mercy, number us among those who have come out of the great tribulation with the seal of the living God on our foreheads and whose robes have been made white in the blood of the Lamb. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Again, thank you for tuning in today as we learn a little bit about Adam and Eve and their greatest descendant, Jesus Christ our Lord. I hope you've enjoyed this. Hope you maybe learned a little something. Our next video will be tomorrow, December 20th, where we study Martin Luther's wife, Katharina von Bora Luther. I hope you tune in for that, and I pray that the Lord blesses the rest of your day.